Hello, good morning dear students. Welcome back to my today's online class. So as already I started the fifth chapter of your syllabus, that is principle of inheritance and variations. So in previous classes we have completed more than half chapter, and in the last class, that is yesterday's class, I completed the points what pedigree analysis. I explained you in yesterday's class what is pedigree analysis. Okay, what are the uses and what are the types of pedigree analysis. So what is pedigree analysis? It is used to what? See the inheritance character which is passes from parents to the offspring of the next generation. And this pedigree analysis is very useful to study about the disorders. Okay, so what? The hereditary disorders which comes from the parents to the offspring of next generation. To study about the family. Okay, what are the inherited characters are passed from parents to the offsprings of next generation? This pedigree analysis is very useful. So it is represented as what? Family tree. So from that we can understand what, how the inherited characters are transferred from parents to offsprings. And in that we have seen the two types of pedigree analysis. First one is autosomal dominant trait pedigree, and second one is autosomal recessive trait pedigree. So in that, both these pedigree, what we have learned, so in the first dominant pedigree, in that we have learned that whenever this parent is affected, then only the offsprings can be affected. So it is called as dominant, because here the dominant what, any one of the parent is affected, which shows, which can able to express its character, and that passes to the next generation. So dominant. And next recessive, in that what, in this case, if the parents are not affected, if the parents are normal, then also what happens? The children of next generation will get affected. So I told you that the two examples for this autosomal as dominant as well as the autosomal recessive. That we have seen in the last class, that is yesterday's class. So in today's class, we'll see the next point. Okay, last point of the chapter, which is very important. And that is called as a genetic disorders. Genetic disorders means what? It is also what comes again regarding the genes of the human. Okay, so because of this what, alteration or addition, deletion of any kind of a gene, these genetic disorders can be occurs in the humans. So these genetic disorders we have to study. These again have the two different types, Mendelian disorders and chromosomal disorders. So Mendelian disorders, in that we have to follow, to study about these disorders, we have to follow first what? The principles of Mendel, principle of inheritance, which is proposed by the Mendel. So according to the Mendel's principle, these are the disorders which passes from parents to the offsprings of next generation. So this is based on what? The study of this genetic disorder or Mendelian disorder is based on the principle of what? Mendelian principle. What is that genetic disorders? What are the different types? And some examples we'll discuss with that, some of the diseases with the symptoms and the characters, how it passes, because of what kind of the addition or deletion of gene we have to see in today's class. So I will start with this topic, genetic disorder. So this is the very last point of this chapter. Genetic disorders. In this topic, these are the genetic disorders we have to study, the human genetic disorders. Okay, so these genetic disorders in human society is studied under a specialized branch, and which is called as the human genetics. First point I will write. Genetic disorder in human society studied under a specialized branch. Specialized branch. Called as human genetics. human genetics. So we are here in this point, we are studying the genetic disorders in a human. So that type of the genetic, that kind of the study is known as the human genetics. So now is for what is mean by human genetics? What is the definition? Human genetics, it is a branch of biology which deals with the study of inheritance of characters in human is known as the human genetics. Genetics means only is what? Study of inheritance of characters in organisms is called as the genetics. Here the term is mentioned, that is human genetics. So what is the definition? The study of inheritance of characters, it is also called as what? Traits in human is called as the human genetics. Okay, got the point here? What is mean by human genetics? Okay, next thing is what here? The genetic disorders are mainly classified into two categories. One is the Mendelian disorders and the second one is the chromosomal disorder. Genetic disorders are classified into two categories. Okay, namely, the first one is, I will write with the Roman one, this is first. So this is what? Mendelian disorders. First one is Mendelian disorders. And the second one is chromosomal disorders. Okay. So as I told you, we have to see the genetic disorders. Genetic disorders in human society studied under a specialized branch which is called as the human genetics. Human genetics, what is the definition? The study of inheritance of characters in human is called as the human genetics. So these are the genetic disorders which are classified under the two categories. First one is the Mendelian disorder and second one is the chromosomal disorder. So now in the next point we have to see what is Mendelian disorders along with some of the disorders, examples we have to see. And next one is the chromosomal disorder. What is mean by chromosomal disorder and what are the examples comes under this chromosomal disorders, that we have to see. Okay. Now we have to see what the next point from this genetic disorder is, the Mendelian disorder. Okay, so the first category we'll see the Mendelian disorder. So why it is called as a Mendelian disorder? Because these are the disorders which comes from what? The inheritance, which comes from parents to the offspring of next generation. So this is based on the law which is proposed by the Mendel, the principles of inheritance. Okay. So first of all, I'll write the first point. The Mendelian disorder, what comes in this is what? These Mendelian disorders are due to alteration or mutation of single single gene has, it is called as, has, is called as monogenic disease. Monogenic diseases. Got the point here? In Mendelian disorders, what happens? Alteration. So as we have seen, the mutation process. Mutation is what? The sudden change in the what? The gene level or chromosome level. That is called as a mutation. So whenever this Mendelian disorder study has been done, at that time what they have observed, this Mendelian disorder is because of the alteration or the mutation of a single gene. Only one gene changes can be occurs. So these are the diseases are called as the monogenic diseases. Understood? And next is, this Mendelian disorders is completely based on the principle of inheritance of principles of inheritance by Mendel. Okay, so this is based on what? The principle of inheritance by Mendel. So these are the disorder because of the presence of a recessive gene on sex chromosome. Because of presence of recessive gene on sex chromosome. Okay, so these are the diseases or disorders because of the presence of recessive gene on sex chromosome. Next point is, if the recessive gene present on the X chromosome, then it is called as a X-linked inheritance. Recessive gene present on X chromosome called as X-linked inheritance. Got the point? Whenever, see, first what I told you, the presence of recessive gene on sex chromosome, and then next what happens, the recessive gene which is present on the X chromosome, it is called as X-linked inheritance. If it is present on the Y chromosome, then it is called as the Y-linked inheritance. Okay. So next here, some of the common Mendelian disorders are there. What are the namely example? I will write here. Hemophilia. Okay, one example is hemophilia. Next is cystic fibrosis. Another example is the color blindness. Next one is sickle cell anemia. Next is thalassemia. And next is phenylketonuria. So these are the some examples of the Mendelian disorders what I have written. So see what are the names. You should remember the examples. Hemophilia, cystic fibrosis, color blindness, sickle cell anemia, thalassemia and phenylketonuria, so on. So this is about the Mendelian disorders. Got the point? First, what I told you, this disorders can happen because of what? The alteration or mutation of a single gene, means changing only a single gene. So it is called as a monogenic diseases. Next one is, these are the diseases which is based on what?
proposed by the Mendel. Next is, here these are the disorder because of the presence of a recessive gene on sex chromosome. If it is, the recessive gene is present on the X chromosome, then it is called as a X-linked inheritance. And next one is, this Mendelian disorders again can, a female which is a carrier, okay, if the gene is present on the X chromosome of the female, which is the carrier, from the female, it can be transferred to the male progeny. And next, the examples which comes under the Mendelian disorders are the hemophilia, cystic fibrosis, color blindness, sickle cell anemia, thalassemia and phenylketonuria. In the next point, what we have to see, some of the examples of the Mendelian disorders. So what I have mentioned, these are the examples. In your syllabus, only the few are there. Only three examples we have to see in detail. What are that? Hemophilia is the first. Second one is the sickle cell anemia. And third one is the phenylketonuria. So out of these, all the Mendelian disorders, we will see only the three. Because of what changes, these diseases, disorders can come in the human of the next generation, which is inherited from the parents to the offspring, that we have to see. Okay? So next, we'll see the first example of the Mendelian disorder, that is hemophilia. This is what? The hemophilia. First point from this is, hemophilia is a Mendelian disorder. Mendelian disorder. Okay, this is the first point. So, hemophilia occurs because of what? Because of the absence of clotting factor in the blood. The hemophilia can occur because of or due to absence of clotting factor in blood. Of the clotting factors. And next one is, It is this hemophilia is because of the presence of presence of recessive gene on X chromosome. So it is the example for X-linked inheritance. It is example of X-linked inheritance. So this hemophilia, the occurrence of hemophilia is more in male as compared to the female. The chances of hemophilia is more in male than female. Why it is like this? Because this for hemophilia, a single recessive gene is enough in male. In female, what happens? The double recessive gene should be there. See, male what here? The male is, sex chromosome is XY. And what is the female? XX. So, because of this hemophilia, one recessive gene what? It is linked on the X chromosome. And then here, only a single gene, recessive gene is enough in male for the hemophilia. If it should be in the female, then what happens? Two recessive genes are needed here. So, the chances of this hemophilia are more in the male than in the female. So, this is about the hemophilia. So, what are the points I told you now? Just like revise. The hemophilia, this is the Mendelian disorder, which is the genetic disorder. It is because of what? It is due to the absence of clotting factor in the blood. It takes a long time to clot the blood. And then here it is also called as the breeder's disease. Remember this. So the question may be asked for 1 mark. Name the breeder disease. Okay. So why hemophilia is called as the breeder disease, like this it will be asked. So it takes a prolonged bleeding from a small injuries because of the absence of the clotting factor. The next one is here. This hemophilia is because of the presence of a recessive gene on the X chromosome. And which is what? It is the X-linked inheritance example. And next one is the hemophilia chances are more in male as than in the female. Because what the reason is? Because in a male, only a single recessive gene is enough for hemophilia. In female, the two recessive genes are required. So this is about the hemophilia. And now you have to see the next example is the sickle cell anemia. Okay. The second example from Mendelian disorder, we'll see the sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia. Okay, so this sickle cell anemia is also what? Mendelian disorder. First point we'll focus is, it is a Mendelian disorder. Okay, and the sickle cell anemia is called as autosomal recessive disorder. So this sickle cell anemia is because of the presence of a recessive gene. Okay, so sickle cell anemia. So infected persons can have the formation or the production of a defective hemoglobin. I will write here the point. So with me, you also note down the point, because in examination, the question may be asked based on this, each one of the example, write a note on hemophilia, write a note on sickle cell anemia. Like that, the examples will be asked for 2 marks or the 3 marks questions. Infants means infected persons. How? Yes, hemoglobin. Yes, hemoglobin, which is defective. Which is defective. See, these hemophilic patients, what the infected persons are there, the persons who has got the severe sickle cell anemia, in that persons what happens? The production of a defective hemoglobin. Defective hemoglobin, which is called as the yes hemoglobin. Yes hemoglobin means, remember, the defective hemoglobin. Okay, so in the normal person, the normal hemoglobin is coded by a gene, that is HbA. Normal hemoglobin is controlled by, it is controlled by gene HbA. Just remember this, very important it is. Okay, normal hemoglobin of a person is controlled by the gene HbA. And next, whereas defective hemoglobin is controlled by GHBS. Got the point? What I told you, the normal hemoglobin is controlled by a gene HbA, whereas the defective hemoglobin gene is controlled by HbS. Okay, so now here, so as you know that it is present in a pair, okay, always the factors are present in a pair. So the normal defective hemoglobin, so normal hemoglobin is, normal hemoglobin, I will write in short HB. Normal hemoglobin is controlled by homozygous alleles. Okay, homozygous allele, that is HbA and HbA. This is normal. So no person can get infected by any kind of a genetic disorder if the hemoglobin is normal. And then next, what happens? The defective hemoglobin. Defective hemoglobin means Hb. So here what happens? The defective hemoglobin, in this what happens if the condition is homozygous? Then Hb, yes, Hb, yes. If it defective hemoglobin in homozygous condition, HbS, HbS, that leads to person chronic hemophilic anemia. Okay, so this is because of what? The because of formation of defective hemoglobin. So how defective hemoglobin is formed? First, I'll write your point. How the defective hemoglobin is formed? The amino acid glutamic acid glutamic
programming as if is replaced by valine. Okay, the amino acid glutamic acid is replaced by valine and formation of this leads to the formation of defective hemoglobin. So this is what I told you. Whenever it is in a homozygous condition, the person will get chronic hemophilic anemia. They suffer from this anemic diseases, that is sickle cell anemia. So this is because of what? Because of the amino acid glutamic acid is replaced by valine and it leads to the formation of defective hemoglobin. This sickle cell anemia is an inborn error. Where what happens? The biconcave RBCs are converted into crescent, that is half moon shaped RBC. Half moon, which is also called as a sickle shape. Are you getting the point? This sickle cell anemia is an inborn error where what happens? The biconcave RBCs are converted to crescent, that is half moon shaped, or it is also called as a sickle shaped RBCs. So in this, what happens? This sickle cell anemia, the defective hemoglobin, I'll write HB, okay? Defective hemoglobin cannot provide enough oxygen. Okay? Enough oxygen. And the sickle shaped RBC are not able to move from small blood capillaries. Hence, a person cannot get enough oxygen and ultimately this anemic disease, that is sickle cell anemia, leads to the death of the person. And then what happens? The last point what I used to tell is, I told you whenever this defective hemoglobin is in a HBS, means homozygous condition, then a person can be get a chronic hemophilic diseases. It is because of what? This formation of the amino acids, that is replaced, glutamic acid is replaced to the valine and defective hemoglobin is formed. So I told you, what happens? The biconcave RBCs are converted into the half moon shaped or the sickle shaped RBCs. So that half moon shaped or the sickle shaped RBCs are unable to move from these smaller blood capillaries. Hence what happens? The person cannot get the enough oxygen and that leads to the death of the person. But one condition is what? If this defective hemoglobin is present in a heterozygous condition, what? Defective hemoglobin. So defective hemoglobin, if it is in a heterozygous condition,
Yes. Heterozygous means half is normal and half is defective. If this condition is there, then the person can be the carrier of this sickle cell anemia and this person cannot die. Okay? So they cannot suffer the problem as much of the homozygous condition. So this is about the sickle cell anemia. So from first point to the last point, once again we'll revise this. The sickle cell anemia, first point is the, it is the Mendelian disorder. And it is called as what? Autosomal recessive disorder because of the presence of a recessive gene. And these infants, infants mean this infected persons of the sickle cell anemia can have the S hemoglobin. S hemoglobin, which is nothing but the defective hemoglobin. So the normal hemoglobin gene is controlled by the HBA, whereas the defective hemoglobin is controlled by the gene HBS. So whenever a person is a normal, so normal hemoglobin, if it is in a homozygous condition, HbA and HbA, so it is what? The person is normal, in which a normal hemoglobin is present. So at the time of the defective hemoglobin, in the homozygous condition, how it is? HbS, HbS. So that leads to the person, the chronic hemophilic anemia. So the person can get, because of the presence of the defective hemoglobin, the person can be get the sickle cell anemia disorder. What happens, how it occurs because of the S hemoglobin, how it forms in a person, that is defective hemoglobin, how it forms means, it forms the amino acid, glutamic acid is replaced by the valine. Remember that this is the amino acid, glutamic acid, which is replaced by valine. Okay, the replacement of only one single amino acid. So because of what here, the defective hemoglobin is formed. The sickle cell anemia is an inborn error. Okay, and here what happens, where the biconcave shaped RBCs are converted to the crescent or half moon shaped RBCs. Okay, so that half moon shaped RBCs are formed. And then what happens, this defective hemoglobin cannot provide enough oxygen to the person. And what, that sickle shape or the crescent shaped RBCs are there, they are not able to move from the small blood capillaries. Hence, the person cannot get the enough oxygen, so the person can suffer from this disease and ultimately that person can be done. Next is, the defective hemoglobin, that is S hemoglobin, if it is in a heterozygous condition, that is Hb and Hb, yes, then here the person can be the carrier of this sickle cell anemia, but they cannot suffer much problems as compared to the homozygous condition person. Okay? So based here, this sickle cell anemia is best example for point mutation. Whenever I taught you about the mutation, I given you the one example, sickle cell anemia for point mutation. Okay? It is an example for point mutation. Very good example for point mutation. Why means only, see you can see on a particular point, only the glutamic acid is replaced by valine. So it is the best example for the point mutation. Understood? So next is, third example from the Mendelian disorder is phenylketonuria. We'll see about the phenylketonuria. So before that, I will tell you one point I left to tell about this hemophilia. The hemophilia, firstly, it is noticed in the royal family of Europe. Royal family of Europe. The hemophilia firstly found observed in the royal family of Europe by the scientist whose name is John Conrad. So he has noticed this hemophilia first in the royal family of Europe, that is the Queen Victoria family. Queen Victoria Royal family. Where that queen is the carrier of the family, and from the Queen Victoria it can transfer to the next generation. The full family is of the hemophilia. And the next one is, so this hemophilia is also called as royal disease. Just remember this point, which is very important. The question may be also called, name the royal disease. Okay, then you have to write the hemophilia. So this is about the hemophilia. Now we'll move to the last example of the Mendelian disorder, that is phenylketonuria. Next, we have to see the last example of Mendelian disorder, that is phenylketonuria, which is also called as PKU. Okay, so the first point in this is also what? The phenylketonuria is the Mendelian disorder. It is a Mendelian disorder. Okay. The next point is, it is autosomal disorder. Due to presence of recessive gene. This phenylketonuria is a inborn error. It is also a inborn error where the infected persons can lack the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Where infected or affected persons lack the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Got the point? The person which is suffering from this phenylketonuria, it is an inborn error where what happens? The affected persons lack the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Where what happens? The essential amino acid phenylalanine is converted into tyrosine. This essential amino acid phenylalanine is converted into tyrosine. Where? Next point I'll write. Then next what happens? The phenylalanine into converts into phenylpyruvic acid. Phenylpyruvic acid. Next, what happens? The phenylalanine is accumulates or converts into the phenylpyruvic acid. This accumulation in brain leads to mental retardation. Got the point? These changes, what it happens, the phenylalanine converts into the phenylpyruvic acid in brain, then what happens, this accumulation in brain leads to the mental retardation. Sometimes what happens, this phenylpyruvic acid also excreted through urine because of poor absorption of kidney. Poor absorption of kidney. Understood? This phenylpyruvic acid is also excreted through the urine because of the poor absorption of the kidney. So the infected person, the person who has get this phenylketonuria disease, the symptoms what we can observe here, the person can have lighter skin, hair color and eye color as compared to their siblings. Got the point? The person who has affected from phenylketonuria, that persons have light skin color, light hair color, light eye color as compared to the siblings. They are nothing but the cousins, which were the normal. But the cousins are normal. So as compared to the cousins, the infected persons can have the light skin color, light hair color and light eye color. And this is what? This is the best example. This phenylketonuria can show the phenylotropy. Phenylotropy. Because a single gene can express more characters. This already we have studied in previous classes. So, I will revise this. This phenylketonuria is because of what? Here, the alteration or change in the chromosome number 12. Change in chromosome 12. Okay, the mutation or change can occur on the chromosome number 12. First of all, I will revise once again this point, phenylketonuria, which is also called as PKU. So this phenylketonuria is known as a Mendelian disorders. It is also called as autosomal disorders due to what? The presence of recessive gene. Next one is, this phenylketonuria is an inborn error where a person affected, they can lack the enzyme. The name of enzyme is phenylalanine hydroxylase. Then later what happens? The essential amino acids, that is phenylalanine, is converted into tyrosine. So this tyrosine is always present in our food. Okay, already it is present in our food. Then what happens? Later, that phenylalanine is accumulated or converts into phenylpyruvic acid. So this accumulation in a brain that leads to the mental retardation. Means the person who can be affected by phenylketonuria, they can suffer from the mental retardation. Then here what happens, this phenylpyruvic acid also excreted through the urine because of the poor absorption of the kidney. And next, a person who was affected by this disease, mammalian disease, that is phenylketonuria. The persons can have light skin color, light hair color, light eyes color as compared to their siblings which were the normal. Then this is the best example for paleotropy, because a change in a single gene can express many characters, can see skin color, eye color and the hair color. So this phenylketonuria is because of the change in the chromosome number 12. So whatever that mutation or change of a gene can occur, it is on the chromosome number 12. So this is about the Mendelian disorder, what we have discussed in today's class. The points which I have covered in today's class is genetic disorder definition. Then I told you the two categories of genetic disorder. One is the Mendelian disorder, another one is the chromosomal disorder. Next we have seen the Mendelian disorder, what are the characters, and three examples, many examples I told you, but three examples in detail we have seen. First we have seen hemophilia, and then next we have seen the sickle cell anemia, and third one is phenylketonuria. The question may be asked based on this for 5 marks, what is genetic disorder? Explain hemophilia, or write a note on hemophilia, write a note on sickle cell anemia, write a note on phenylketonuria. These are the questions it may be asked for 3 marks or 5 marks question in your examination. So the next category, the second category of genetic disorder, that is chromosomal disorder, we'll see in the next class. Until that, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.